One thing again, I'd like to, in the practical example, if you see, the lord of this house, this nakshatra is what? Venus. Where is Venus sitting? In the sixth house of scandals, sixth house of lawsuits, and it's retrograde. Okay. And Venus is what? The fifth lord of power, the tenth lord of profession. And the ten, can you see the correlation?
That will affect him there directly.
Yeah, it will affect him there directly. It will affect him there. I mean, I've seen beautiful examples like that. So, now see, let's see the symbol. The symbology is transformation, is the yoni. The yoni is very secretive, the vulva, the female genital organ, the female reproductive organ. So you do not, it was Yudhishthir who cursed his mother and said that, you know, earlier on a child was born and nobody came to know about it, that the lady was carrying a child. It was Yudhishthir who cursed his mother, if you remember, when after Karna's death, when she asked him to cremate Karna. Karna, after the battle of Mahabharata, then yes. She says that somebody has to do the creation or cremation for Karna also. And then Yudhishthir questions and they come to know that yes, he was their eldest brother. So Yudhishthir curses her and says that no lady can hide secrets. So they say, that is how they always say that, you know, ladies can't keep secrets. So it was because of the curse of Yudhishthir. And a child will be, so when a child is going to be born, it will become apparent to everybody that a child is to be born. So it is a, see, until and unless after a certain, you know, certain time has passed, then only you come to know that there is something that is going to be taking birth. So it's a creative process here again. It's a secretive process. At the same time, it is a creative process because creation of a new being. And transformation, not just of the lady concerned, but a transformation in the entire life of the people involved. Check it out. It is also something that, you know, how I can also interpret it as something that holds and supports. So this nakshatra is something to do with helping others also, nurturing others also. So these people have the ability to nurture others around them. Or people who come in their, in their embrace, within their boundaries, they help these people. They are very good nurturers. They have very strong, because this is associated primarily, because you saw the yama and the yami and you saw the sexual, interpretation to it. So this is also a lot to do with sexuality. So if, see, you saw the assault, okay, in the case of allegation, in case of Clarence Thomas. And you also, I mean, you've been given a life, you gave me a live example. See, that man was asked to create a baby for, with somebody, random person, and then to have a relationship, a physical relationship with one, with a wife of his boss. So this has got a lot to do with this. And when
I've seen the dashas are permitting that, then these things come up more. It's not that the whole life it will be like this. Houses, then, and I have to confirm that with him what dasha he was running that time.
No, it's also not just the dasha. Also, it's like if you take up the BCP or the nakshatra ages. So in a particular year, if that nakshatra is, apparent, working, then definitely that person will be open to such suggestions or that.
Okay.
So, see, if Venus dasha has passed in his youth, you know, there is just, he's not even 20. If the moon is in Bharani, the Venus dasha, if he's born in the second pada, okay,
yes,
and so So Venus Dasha, at least 5 years, 6-7 years have gone by. So only 13 years are left. So how can anybody, he can, you know, God not willing, somebody can make passes or something nonsense can happen. But keeping that aside, he cannot procreate at that age.
Yes.
So how do you understand whether it's, then how do you, but that those instances will happen with this person later on in life. So it's not really the Venus Dasha that is operating.
Yes.
It could be that house is activated during that BCP time. Or one of the nakshatra ages are working. Either of it. Or if Venus Dasha, if somebody is born, say, in Mercury Mahadasha. So Venus Dasha will come to this. These things will happen.
Okay.
Somebody is born in Revati. So when Venus Dasha comes for this person, and all these things are happening.
Yes.
So we were talking about secrecy. We're talking about removal of life. We're talking about, and I have always maintained that this guy, I have spoken about him on your channel on, I think, Ashlesha Nakshatra. I had his chart. This is one of the most fascinating charts for me, because somebody who can annihilate over 30 million people, you know, in a matter of so many years, just 13 years, 30 million people, is not an ordinary person. And you see his seventh lord of enemies, open enemies, is sitting there in Bharani Nakshatra. He married one of his cousins, you know, daughter of one of his cousins. So we had talked about incest. Okay. And then Venus is also in the same nakshatra of Bharani. It's the Lagna Lord. It's retrograde. It's the eighth lord of incest. It's the lord of self. It's the eighth lord of sudden life and death changes. And you see, his entire life has been governed by these two planets.
Yes, totally.
And again, he was born in Purva Ashada Nakshatra. Okay. So, his Venus Dasha went off very early in life, in the first 20 years.
Yes.
So, he shouldn't have been subjected to... So, the Venus should have lost its potency to deliver on these grounds. But it did not stop. Why? Because Venus is the Lagna Lord. And wherever Lagna Lord sits, it's one of our high points in our life. And two, there must be some trigger points. When the Lagna Nakshatra is triggered, okay. Now, Lagna is also in the Chitra Nakshatra, Nakshatra of Mars. There is Mars going and sitting. Mars is going and sitting in Venus's. So there's a strong connect between Mars and Venus in his chart.
Yes.
And when the seventh house will get activated, when the second house will get activated, when the Lagna will get activated, when the eighth house will get activated, these things are going to happen in his life. Or when Chitra Nakshatra or Bharani Nakshatra gets activated, then these things will happen in his life. So there are lots and lots of things. Or when Mars Dasha comes for him. So you see, when is Mars Dasha coming? Mars Dasha will come after Venus. Then you have Sun, Moon, Mars.
So around maybe 30s or 20s, that time.
Exactly.
30s likely.
See, 20 years gone. Okay. Sun, 6 years gone. Okay. And then...
Just 14 degrees. So it's just Purva Ashada.
Yeah. So I'm taking the entire 20.
Yes.
I'm taking the entire 20. Okay.
36 years.
36 years are gone. And when Mars Dasha comes in. Or you take it 32. Because it's 14 degrees something. Right? 20 minutes. So nearly 1 degree is off. 13 degree, 20 minutes, Mula, and 14 degrees.
Yes, yes. 20. Yeah, around so 33, around that.
33. So you add 33 to this. 1889 plus 33. 2, 1 carry up to 1901. No, 90 plus, okay. Wait, 90 plus 30. Huh. So, 20. 14 to 23. Let's take it like that. 1923.
Around that time when this World War thing was going on.
Yes. And he was, he moved from Germany to Austria and all these places, and everything happened.
Yeah, and so maybe by the time, maybe by the time Mars ended, he was established as a dictator.
Yes. So he was forming, all those plans were going on in his life.
Yes.
So, lots, nakshatra analysis, we can move it on to a different level altogether, you know, but when you're doing event time prediction. So, in Bharani, there will always be a woman responsible for getting some change in your life. It could be your mother, it could be your sister, it could be a girlfriend, some lady involved, a planet, to bring about that change.
And this is like only for a man, or even for ladies, it will be a lady?
Well, it will be, it will more so for a man, but then okay. Ladies also.
Could be mother or anybody also.
Could be mother, could be aunt, could be anybody. Could be somebody who's given you such a bad stepmotherly treatment that you have lost all faith in the womankind. Anything.
Okay. It will depend on which house, you know, that is linked, I guess.
Yes, exactly. It will depend on the planet. It will depend on the house. Now, see, if I go back to the chart of Adolf Hitler, see his grandmother. Okay, his grandmother. Maternal, and I am quoting from Wikipedia. I'm not saying anything that is mine.
So fourth from fourth.
And sorry, paternal grandmother. So not fourth from fourth, but 12th. Okay. 12th.
Nine. Yeah, fourth from the ninth. Paternal.
But the thing is, Venus. Venus is also Karaka for ladies.
Hmm.
Okay, and I've already said that this nakshatra has to do a lot with ladies. And Babaji, we've talked for nearly 2 hours. So, so this nakshatra has got a lot to do with ladies, okay? So, you see, his paternal grandfather was working with, paternal grandmother was working in a house of Jews, okay?
Okay.
And the son of the house, and she went into a relationship where Hitler's father was conceived. That lady, she was working, his grandmother was working in that house. Definitely, she was in those times and days. It is, we are talking about somewhere around 1850s at the very least. At the very least, the Middle Ages. You know, so she was let go on. She was asked to leave the house. So she was pregnant, she was single, and she had no work. Don't you think that would have had a very strong bearing in the lives for the two generations at least?
Yes.
And you see what happens, what he does to the Jews when he grows up. And for that matter, other religions, races which he considers not the Aryan race. He also was very strong on the gypsies. And
this trait also, no, of an elephant.
Excuse me?
Elephant and Bharani are related. No?
Okay, they are, but you know.
Because I have heard that whenever moon transits, you know, Bharani, most of the times there's traffic jam, and you know, elephant is that.
No, so. That's with Revati.
Okay, yeah, Revati is there, and Purva Bhadrapada is also linked, I guess.
Yes. Because it's the elephant's tusks.
Yeah, because day before yesterday, moon was in Purva Bhadrapada. And in my hometown, Guwahati, what happened?
So I was saying, sorry, it is Purva Ashada. Purva Ashada is related to Bhar in that case. Related to elephants in that case. Trunk, tusk of that. Ability, Uttara Ashada has the tusks.
Yeah, Uttara Ashada is directly.
Yeah. So for Revati also is with you know, with jams and traffic jams and
motion. Okay. Today moon is in Revati.
Today moon is moving into Revati. Tomorrow it will continue into Revati and go over to
In fact, I was waiting for moon to enter in Revati, and then I had to send a mail. So as soon as it entered, I had sent. I think we can proceed to the remedies if it is there.
Yeah, so I just wanted to tell you that, you know, the transformational effect with regards to women in case of adulthood. Okay. So, planet is Venus. We've been talking about Venus for so long. So, you know, people watching this nakshatra videos would definitely know about the basic of planets Venus. So, and when we're talking about incest, when we're talking about sexual allegations, Monica Lewinsky, she doesn't fall short. You know, you have to mention her. She has a moon in this nakshatra in the 8th house of sex and scandals. See, what happens is one nakshatra has a certain quality, a certain point, okay? And every planet also, every house also has certain points. Every sign has certain points. So we leave the sign aside because the sign is made of the nakshatra. So definitely the nakshatras are imparting those points. But when every house has a certain connotation, certain karakas, sex and scandal are a part of the 8th house. And when it moves into Bharani Nakshatra in the 8th house, it becomes so very obvious. So that is also one way of correlating and understanding. So we can move into remedies now. See, male elephant, as you said. Okay. So the bird is crow, and there's also a very beautiful story, but I'll just keep one thing straight. If you have a problem with Bharani, you should feed the crow. This is one of the remedial measures, because the crow represents, it is the animal of Bharani Nakshatra, because Bharani is your ancestors and the crow is a messenger of your ancestors. If you're having problems in your family, feed crows. And I have seen, Babaji, I've seen a video which really broke my heart, where people are actually in holding the crow and saying that, you know, you must be knowing that we give, when we're doing the tarpanam, we give, set aside some food for the crow. In fact, even in daily, day-to-day life, you should set aside some food for the crow. So when we are doing the tarpanam, you set aside certain food for the crow. And if the crow is not fulfilled, then you have a certain bone of contentions with your ancestors. So the family may not prosper. And Bharani Nakshatra has a lot to say, like Magha Nakshatra, about the ancestors. Don't forget that Magha Nakshatra is its paramitra. Okay, so Tarabalam holds there. So you must satisfy the crow also. That is one remedial measure that I would always prescribe to a Bharani Nakshatra person. Keep food aside for the crow and you will see yourself growing. Like for the Pushya Nakshatra person, if you give a roti, or if you give, you know, bread, not bread, but if you give some food or hay or something to the cow, you will see a lot of prosperity in your life. So, I make it a standard point on your channel at the very least to say, don't do the Bija Mantras. Until and unless you are initiated and you are helped by a guru. Bija Mantras can be very, very potent. It's the Bijasha Shakti. And when it grows, it can take a form that you are not aware of and you might be caught unawares. So, until assisted, until guided by a guru, do the Vishnu Sahasranam, that is much better, depending on the pada your moon is or your planet is. Okay, and there are a lot of remedial measures that one can do with Bharani. The most important is, you know, the amla tree you can water, because we did. What is that? Amla tree is the tree. So you can water the amla tree. You can you can do a lot of remedial measures, in the sense that, you know, if you are facing a shortage on this day, then don't loan money to people when Bharani moon is transiting this sign. Keep 5 kgs sugar or sea salt at home to invite prosperity. If your sugar content at home should never be less than 5 kgs.
Okay.
These 3 dots of Bharani, red dots, 3x3 inch paper, 3 red dots, a triangle. What triangle? This is a equilateral triangle. Mm-hmm. And keep it laminated. It acts like a yantra.
Okay.
Bharani is also about your relationships. So certain measures to do for relationships, you can do it on the nakshatra of Bharani.
Mm-hmm.
So even a Bharani is the vulva. We've seen that, right? The female genital organ, which is a reproductive organ. So if you get Friday plus Bharani nakshatra plus Trayodashi, because Trayodashi is ruled by Kama, Yama, Kama desires. So if you desire a child and if there's a Trayodashi, which is when you come to permutation combination, you will see a long, long list of it. So it's a Friday and Bharani and Trayodashi, you conceive a child on that day, there's no chance of miscarriage. Okay. Professions are many and you can do a lot of activities, auspicious activities on that day. One of them is being a good lawyer, passing a good judgment, an unbiased judgment also. You can do work which requires self-discipline because Yama is very disciplined. You can to conceive a child, you can have a relationship on that day, or you can do good labor. Okay, if you have something bad sitting there, then it can make you do evil deeds. Or you would be provoked to do evil deeds. But the final decision is always on evil.
Especially in Rohini and this Bharani, I have always seen some temptation or the other always comes with me. It always happens. I don't know.
You must be having some planet in the nakshatras opposite Rohini or Bharani.
Could be.
So that makes you come out. The inner person is hidden. The first 6 houses is hidden. It will find a reflection in the 7th from itself. That means. So this is the temple you can nakshatra temple that you can contact where you can do the pujas if you have a problem with your Bharani nakshatra.
Amazing.
So that brings me to the end of this session.
Amazing. We were planning to do Mula Nakshatra, but then we ended up doing Bharani because Venus is exalted now in transit. And Mula, we will do it very soon. Maybe when Jupiter enters Mula that time. In fact, it had entered already.
Yeah, but it had entered and so when it enters for the final time in its own house in, nakshatra of one of the most sattvic planets, Ketu. So then we can, for the final time. In the meantime, we can schedule something when Rahu goes into the nakshatra of Adra. So we can do that then.
All right. Thank you very much. And for those who don't know, she also has a channel and you'll find the link in the description section. You can go there and subscribe. And you also do consultations. I will also give the link to her website below. So please go out and check. And you also have the new calendar.
Yeah, the nakshatra calendar. So just for records, this is the nakshatra calendar. Wherein we have a lot of details about the nakshatra for everybody to learn the basics. And we also have a book accompanying the nakshatra calendar, which tells you how to deal with the nakshatras in your everyday life.
Okay, interesting. Yes, you can go to her website and check. lots of books, I guess. On Pushya also you have one book, and 27 or something like that, you have another book.
27 nakshatras in 27 days. So how to learn, they are the just 10 points from each nakshatra, and how do you learn them, how you can, there's so many facets of the nakshatras, you know, that it's not possible to cut, you know, in a 2-hour session to work on. So the book especially will deal in intensive, and the classes also deal with intensive points on each such planet.
All right. Thank you very much. We will get
to
it again. Thank you for coming.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Namaste.